President Marcos addresses the recent shakeup in the military. He says the reappointment of General Andres Centeno as Chief of the Armed Forces of the Philippines is meant to rationalize seniority in the military. Marcos adds he consulted with members of the AFP before tapping Centeno to replace Lieutenant General Bartolome Vicente Bacaro.
Rationalize namin yung seniority kasi Andy Centeno has 4 stars and Bob Bacaro had 3 stars. So kailangan natin ayusin kasi magkakagulo dun sa baba. So there were some comments that were made sa paano yan, pag nag-extend, kami naman dito sa lower ranks, eh, hindi nakagula na kaming pag-asa. So, hindi naman tama yun. So malo-low moral sila. So tinignan na, what do you want us to do? Nagtanong kami sa military. And I said, ayusin namin yung seniority. And that's what we've done.
Marcos also defends his decision to appoint former Duterte administration officials to key government posts. Carlito Galvez is the new head of the Defense Department, while Eduardo Anio is now the National Security Advisor, replacing Clarita Carlos.
Why Secretary? Why Ed Anio? Because he has a long experience in intelligence. Before he became Chief of Staff, before he became Commander, he was a GSAP. So sanay na sanay yan, and he's well known, and he knows all of the operatives in the intelligence.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. embarks on his 8th foreign trip as Philippine leader. He is in Switzerland this time to present the Philippines as the next top investment destination during the World Economic Forum in Davos. Also on the table, a soft launch of the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund before the world's elite.
Pare-pareho naman yung ginagawa natin dito sa mga trips. We talk about the Philippines, what the situation is as an investment destination. Now that's added to that, meron na tayong pwedeng pag-usapan na sovereign wealth fund. So sasabihin ko, exactly what's happened, that we are forming a sovereign wealth fund for investments for big investments in the basic areas such as agri, energy, digitalization, climate change, yun. But the point being is that now there is a wealth fund.
The theme of this year's World Economic Forum is cooperation in a fragmented world. It's the first face-to-face meeting since the pandemic hit. Former Philippine Socioeconomic Planning Chief Ernesto Pernia not in favor of the planned soft launch of the Maharlika Investment Fund in Davos. Pernia says it's a premature move since the measure was not even scrutinized by the Senate. He adds the Philippines does not need the fund right now.
There are many other ways of getting funds. I don't see why an MIF is a magic wand that will bring about all kinds of these funds into the country. I don't see why it is necessary at this time. As I've said, funds are needed now, not in the long run. Having that MIF now is not really the answer to solving our current needs.
Pernia, meanwhile, agrees with observations. The president is traveling too much. He says 8 foreign trips in 7 months is excessive.
When you keep repeating what you have said before, what you have mentioned before regarding the need for investments from other countries, then that is hard selling. I mean, that is not going to be effective because maybe some countries will be turned off by too much, pushing for what it wants. I think he's trying to to change the perception of the Marcos years. Because the Marcos years is still quite, people are still conscious. Other country leaders are still conscious of what happened in during the Marcos years martial law. So mm-hmm. I guess he might be trying to recover, to to remedy what the perception has been in the past.